Hello, everyone, and welcome back to E2E. Today, we are finally going after the thing that I said that we needed last episode and the thing that I said we were going to do last episode before we got sidetracked into making the farm. We are going to try to make a coke oven, and we are going to go down the good old Immersive Engineering quest page. We're going to see how far we can get, try to make a coke oven. We might get to blast furnace. I actually have no idea about any of this. I've never touched this mod in my life. So, yeah, it's going to be interesting. It's going to be full of failures and stupid decisions, but it's going to be funny, hopefully. So, yeah, I guess we should get started on that. But before we do that, we need to actually unlock the gate for it. So we need to make a coke brick. So we need porcelain, clay, brick, and sandstone. How do you get porcelain clay? Okay, basically, I could do this right now. Okay, that's not too bad. I guess we could do that. But another thing that I've noticed, right, is when I was going to my good old cooking station, right, I realized that I can't make most of the recipes, you know? Because, like, let's just click on one of these things. I don't have a mixing bowl, right? Let's see, what else do I not have? I don't have a cutting board. I don't have a pot. I don't have a knife. So I'm thinking I should just get all of those. Now, I'm pretty sure I found the list of where they are. Right here, cutting board, pot, skillet, saucepan, blah, blah, blah. So basically, I think I'm just going to go through and make all these. And then when I find one that I don't have access to, I'll just make that on the side. So first order of business today, I guess let's just get all these so I can make some, you know, actual food. All right, cutting board, done. Pot, done. Skillet, done. Saucepan, done. Bakeware, done. Mortar and pestle, done. I might already have one of those, but that's fine. Mixing bowl, done. And knife. I'm missing a knife handle, which I need a leather and a stick. All right, made up the knife. We just kind of shove these in here. Boom, 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 boom. Really don't care about the order. And there we go. That should be all of the stuff that I need. I can probably make every single recipe in here now, which is very good. All right, well, I suppose we should actually, you know, make the coke brick now. So I need 4 bricks, sandstone, and porcelain clay, which I believe I can do right now. So let's get started on that. What is that? All right, coke brick. Bam. Now that should give me the quest complete. Yes, it did. Very nice, which means I can get iron plates, fluid pump, and a portable tank. Cool, and that also means I now have access to the Immersive Engineering tree, which starts off with telling me what to do. Okay, so now that I've got this tree unlocked, we can go and read through this. Okay, welcome to Immersive Engineering. This mod primarily offers large multi-block machines with cool aesthetics. Tier 1 tech mod. Oh god, okay. Speed and energy requirements of the machines have been heavily modified. Okay, good to know. This chapter leads to mechanism. You can barely see that. Okay, we also get a engineer's hammer and an engineer's manual, which is good, because I feel like we're going to need those. First thing we need to do, probably coke oven. That seems like the best idea. So I need 27 coke bricks, and I probably need to look in that book on how to make one. All right, so here we go. Found the coke oven in the little book here. It says it basically is the first important machine you make. It heats up coal, blah, blah, blah. It makes coal coke, which is a very nice fuel. And also it makes creosote oil, which is good for the preservation of wood, which is exactly why we're doing this, so we can make chests easier. To form a coke oven, arrange 27 of the coke bricks, probably in a 3x3x3 cube, and then right-click one of the side center blocks with the engineer's hammer. Seems easy enough. Are you telling me that last episode I went on like a 25-minute quest to find a cow, and there was one right here? All right, local river has been successfully pillaged. I now have enough for the porcelain, the bricks, and then some extra because I've used literally every single piece that I had at my base. You know, I totally forgot. We need bone meal to get the porcelain clay as well. So I need to figure out how I'm going to get a lot of that. I have an idea. I don't like the idea, and I only have 4 left. So I think we're just going to have to go to the nether. Oh, did you see that, dude? I'm literally the best Minecraft player. Oh my god.
Stop the cap.
All right, coke oven time. Oh, man. Wait, hold on. I think I did the math wrong. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24. I did the math wrong. I made way more than I needed to. I needed half a stack, not a stack and a half. Okay, well, anyways, I have a whole bunch of this extra stuff now. Whoops. All right, coke oven time. And then I believe you just hit the center with the hammer. And now we have a coke oven. I believe we just put the coal in there, and then it'll make stuff. Maybe? All right, I got half a stack of coal. I think that'll do. And it's just going, so we just gotta let it sit, and then it should make creosote. And now we can treat wood, and we have coke as well, which I believe is a better fuel source, right? Yeah, it literally burns twice as long as coal does. That is very awesome. I just opened a loot box, and I got an ender pouch. It's literally 2 inventory backpack. All right, so with that knocked out of the way, I bet we should probably go for one of these other ones. Okay, treated wood. Treated wood is useful in a lot of recipes in immersive engineering. It's also a great looking building block. So basically we just have to make treated wood. So we need a bucket of creosote oil and then planks. How much do we have? 500. And we need 1,000 mill buckets for a bucket. So we're almost there. Nice. Creosote oil. Can I put this on the floor? Yes. Okay, let's... What did I just get? Flammable! Oh! Yo, it's gambling time, boys. I got tall, slimy grass.
That's... I don't know. That doesn't sound like something that lets you skip progression, though.
Okay. All right, so next up, we have our treated planks. Should we make an engineer's workbench? I feel like that's important, but I think we should maybe get the blast furnace first. I don't actually know what these do, but I feel like that's important, and it looks like it's just a 3x3x3 again, so let's just build that next. Oh, not you again. I hate these things, dude. There is another fortress near the portal, so we're gonna go on a nether adventure. I heard a blaze. Where is it? Oh, there's two blazes. Oh, dude, please. Got one?
Mod folder. Oh. You have to put it.
Firefox! I got the other blaze rod. Let's leave. What's that? Fire bat! Oh, it blew me up! Ugh! Nice. Blast breaks have been acquired. Let's put this sucker right down next to this one. And we have a blast furnace. Okay, now I need to figure out how to use it. All right, blast furnace is done. We can claim our thing. What does it want me to do next? Improve the blast furnace. I would assume I need steel. Yes, that is exactly what I need. Okay, so basically I believe this makes steel, which is good because steel is important. So let's make some steel. Okay, so I put some iron in here. I assume that we need coke. So I'm just going to put one piece in there. We're going to see how much it makes. Oh yeah, there we go. Don't know what I'm going to use the steel for, but we have it. Maybe I should make an alloy kiln. Oh, I need bricks. It literally is one iron ingot and one coke per steel ingot. Oh, and this thing is so slow. Oh no. Oh, I figured out why you need steel. You need steel to make the mechanism steel casing so you can start getting into mechanism. I hate everything. No! No, wait! It blew up my milk cow thingy!
No!
No! Okay, well, I fixed the thing, but I now need to get a new cow, which is extremely... Wait a minute! Flashback.
There was one right here?
Well, hello, Mr. Cow. Get in the hole. Good grief. All right, steel is finally done. We also got 16 pieces of slag. Now, I don't actually know what we need to do with this steel here. Maybe we need to make it with the kinetic dynamo. Nope, that's something else. I have no idea what we need this for, but we have it now. All right, I think I'm just gonna keep going with the immersive engineering trees. Do we wanna make an alloy kiln or an engineer workbench next? I don't think we're going to get even close to enough steel to make a reinforced blast furnace, although I guess I could check how to make one. You know, theoretically, I could actually do that. Molten aluminum brass, and we pour that onto the cast. You don't actually need to use gold for these, which I did not know yestertime. All right, now we need to melt down our steel ingots and cast them into plates. All right, steel plates have been made. Hopper has been made. Let's get this advanced blast furnace. Reinforced blast bricks are done. And hit this with a hammer. Oh! Nice! Look at that! Alright, so it looks like for this quest we also need some preheaters, which is iron sheet metal. Oh no. Oh, this is a crafting tree. Okay, I'll get to work on that. Okay, so new problem just came up. We have a lot of copper, but we are very much out of iron, so I think I'm gonna have to go on a little bit of a mining session to get some more resources so we can actually build those two air addition thingies. Blast furnace preheater, which I think just kind of sucks air into the blast furnace and makes it go faster. So, mining trip. There's a block on the ground that it does not give you the little pop-up when you look at it. I think that means it's a trap. Nope, we're good. You ready for this? So I did a little mining off camera. We got mostly a lot of redstone, a lot of gold. We got an extra bit of copper. We got 5 stacks of iron ore, which is very good considering that's what I went down there for. Plus I also got a piece of magnesium, which I think that was rare considering I've only found one. And then also I got a whole bunch of other garbage, like some Thaumcraft crystals, Surtis quartz, blah, blah, blah. That's a pretty good haul. Oh yeah, right, I forgot. I also got these out of a dungeon chest. Yep, look at me. I'm cool. Now that I've got all those ores, we can actually start working on the blast furnace preheaters. So what do I need? Iron sheet metal, 4, 7. So I need 4 crafts worth for 16 iron plates. Okay. Soul bead. I ate it, and now I'm cursed.
Well, why did you do that?
It was edible. All right, got all that sheet metal crafted up. Next up is the external heater, which we need two of. So we're going to need 8 iron, 6 copper, and 2 redstone. And then the other part, but that other part takes a lot of various other resources that I think I need to get into something else to do. There's just mobs spawning in the day. What is going on? I figured it out.
What is...
I am cursed.
Oh, because you ate the thing.
I ate the thing, and I bet it's just spawning things, and now I have to sit in a hole for 15 minutes. Okay, see you guys in 15. All right, got the iron and copper that we need and the redstone. Got that all smelted down with the Tinker's Furnace. Next up, we need a copper coil block, which means we need another iron. We need some LV wires, which means we need copper wire, which means we need shears and a copper plate. Okay, how many of those do I actually need, though? Okay, we need 2 copper coil blocks, so we need 16 LV wire coils, so we need to craft this 16 times, so we need a stack of copper wire. Could also use a metal press, or I could just use shears because I have shears already and copper plates, so let's just get 1 stack of copper plates. Another thing that I've seen is I can put any kind of ore underneath a small plate presser and then double the output because the pulverized stuff smelts into an ingot each. And I couldn't originally make this when I was looking at other stuff because the piston was not doable, but now that I have treated wood, I can actually do this. So I think I'm just gonna make that. All right, there's our piston and there is the small plate presser. I'm going to steal this right here. I think I can just do this, place that temporarily, that there, and then a lever, and then if I just put the ore in there, that just doubles it. Nice. All right, so now hopefully that should automatically dump the copper that I'm melting into there, which then gets put into a nice hopper and put into this chest here, so I don't have to sit here and click this 64 times. All right, well, I may or may not have just made a stack of copper ingots without realizing they needed to be plates, and now I have to melt them down and forge them again. Oh my god. I also got a nano suit body armor. I feel like this is good, because it's got 8 armor and 2 armor toughness, and it doesn't seem to be breaking. All right, I got my copper plates. Let's snip these into wires. That almost killed my shears, but that's fine. Next step, make coils. We need 16 sticks. I made too many sticks, so that's fine. I need them anyway. There's our wire coils. Did I really just make too many wire coils? I think I did, you know. Yeah, I did. I needed 16 of them, not a stack. I made a stack. Well, all right. Well, there is our 2 coil blocks that we need. And there we have our 2 external heaters. Spread the warmth. Nice. Let me grab these metal sheets like that and like that, and boom, boom. Quest completed. Very nice. Let's actually get this built now. All right. Smack this with a hammer, and I assume that they go right here. Oh, yep. And then right there. Looks pretty legit to me. I don't know how those work, though. I might have to put some energy in them because it does say IF right there. Ow! Okay, 40 flux per tick to operate each of these blast furnace preheaters. Now, unfortunately, I don't have a way to make flux per tick yet, so they're just going to kind of sit there, but at least my furnace looks cool. All right, I think to finish up this episode, I'm going to get the engineer's workbench real quick because that's just treated wood, a treated wood fence, and a crafting table, and then that would be a very good start on immersive engineering, I think. And with that, there is our engineer's workbench. Time to tinker. Slap this down maybe right here. That looks pretty good. I just opened up my loot box that I got, and I got an advanced computer. Right. We might as well make this engineer's blueprint as well. It's just blue dye, paper, and then various metals. Might as well. All right, here's our blueprint. Not a clue what this does. Did that count? Yeah, there we go. Okay. Nice, and that would now unlock the metal press molds. Oh, this is for, like, the press machine, so then you can press things more efficiently, but good for me. I've got this, and I think this in the Tinker's Construct furnace, so I don't really have to worry about that right now. Alrighty, and with that blueprint being crafted, I think we are going to call it for today. We got a lot of stuff done, basically an early introduction to immersive engineering, and then of course we improved our blast furnace, which is a little bit more than an early introduction, but still, getting into immersive engineering, pretty good. We got maybe a good third. If I could find the actual correct tab, geez. So maybe like a third of this done. I bet it's going to get really complicated in these parts, though, because, you know, I bet the high voltage energy stuff is going to be a very long crafting tree. But You know, we got a good start on it. I'd say that's pretty good. Next time, I think I'm either going to continue on this, maybe go for the medium volt, mid volt, whatever, and maybe get the alloy kiln as well, and then definitely the kinetic dynamo so I can start powering these preheaters, because then we can make steel faster. And then maybe we will also go and just knock out some of these gate quests, because there looks to be some pretty good rewards in here, like, you know, 64 rubber, some overclocker upgrades, you know, stuff like that. Aqueous accumulator? Yeah, I think we should just, like, knock out a whole bunch of these, you know, just to get these quest lines started and to get some nice resources from the quest rewards. Okay, that's what we're going to do. All right, with that being said, that's all for today. I'm going to look at this blast furnace because it kind of looks like a spaceship if you tilt your head, kind of. I don't know. Goodbye.